What's up, everyone? Steve here again from RC Tanks and Trucks 24/7. We have something pretty cool from the team at RC Rabbit. They sent me these awesome accessories for RC crawlers. So they have a few different things. I'll leave a link down below if you want to go check them out. But we have two of their products. Now, these are for, I guess, crawlers ranging from 1/24 scale to 1/10 scale. And as you can see, not everyone can build an awesome, you know, state-of-the-art crawling course. These guys have these awesome products, so you can build them indoor or outdoor. Now check out this. This is the rope bridge. So you know, you go over it. Look at that. It's really nice rope there. It's got these kind of plastic or Delrin sleeves in between to keep that gap. That's pretty cool. It's pine, but I do like it. It's got some little stickers there and the RC Rabbit logo on there as well. But check out that. And the cool thing about this is you can attach them together. So if you wanted to make it longer, you can. You attach two together. That comes with all the hardware needed, but you can also attach it together. See, like that? Pretty cool. But it comes with all the hardware. It comes with nails or screws as well, and it's got those little connection points there where you screw them together, and you can make one long bridge. Now, the other product that we have here, so they have others, but like I said, leave the link down below, is a teeter totter. Comes with two sizes, 70 and 140 centimeters. So this is 100, well, that's 1.4 meters. That's pretty big, but we have the 70 centimeter one here. So look at that. Really nice. Quickly open it up. Now, like always when I do these videos, it's always raining, but I guess we can maybe just set up a course in the garage, Zach, or inside. Give it a totter. Packaging is really good, but like I said, as always, comes with the parts and hardware needed as well. Excellent. So, sample ties. Smell the pine, fresh pine. Smells really, really nice. Teeter totter with blocks. So it gives you, like, I guess, different timings you can put down there. You can write on there if you really want to. Comes with a little flag as well. So I guess what we'll do, we'll put it together. Instruction manual. So it shouldn't be too hard. 1, 2, 3, 4. Total of 10 steps. Oh, it's optional there. Oh, you can put those little steps there. That's pretty cool to make it even more difficult getting up teeter totter. So obviously with these, you want to try and get to a point where it kind of balances out, not too quickly, not too slow, and then get to the top and then you kind of slowly drive back down. But let's get all this stuff together and we'll see how it looks. All right, let's quickly put these together on camera, show how easy it is. Like I said, everything is supplied. So these instructions. A few wakatakas there. Comes with these nice rubber feet too, so if it's on a slippery surface, I've got a side underneath there. Right, so that's step one and two. Now step three is getting this first step, and we'll be putting center beam in. Also, it's numbered too, so you don't, you know, if you need to know where, what piece you need. So now we're going to get to step four. Same as step three, obviously just the other side. And what I like about it, so it's got that sticker, like I said before, but you can always use the whiteboard markers and write down the times. You can wipe them off later, but put the screw in already. Same as step three, put these two sides together. The good thing about using screws, you can always take it apart for storage. Number five, we have these rails here, and we're going to be attaching the spaces in between. So that's all it is. Step five, super easy. And six, and six. It goes there. So four screws, there's two spaces, and that's it. There is your teeter totter. You have these little blocks that you can, if you want, they're optional. You put on the main ramp here. There. It's got double-sided tape. That is 6 millimeter high, I believe, 10 millimeters. And you can stick in there if you want to make it a little bit more challenging. The next part is putting it through. Now, the good thing about it, you can have different adjustments. See, you've got three different height adjustments. So depending on your crawler size, you've got these pins. Pretty self-explanatory. Find the hole and put it through, and then just pick the hole you want, and that's it. All right, all done. Check out that. Last steps. Put the flags in. It's actually the last step. You put the flag in. There's a little pre-drilled hole. Stick it in there, and that's it. Good as gold. There we go. over time, obviously you can get a little bit looser with constant use, but that's fine, that's the whole point. But there we go, so great, isn't it? You can put these wherever you want them, start and finish. I think we can set them up somewhere, get the rope bridge. Start up, of course, we've got the bridge, teeter totter, another bridge, onto the ladder. Now we're just using clamps, don't need to use screws, so, and I got some real world, you know, stuff here all over my bench, batteries, motors, all that kind of stuff. Stuff you expect in a RC garage, but let's go, let's have a look. Go down here, push these down. There we go. Ooh, nice one. I'll leave a link in the description of this. Is the 1/18 scale Glacier. Hard body, it's like the K10 Chevy from SMS. Towards the same thing. Look at this. And if you get it just right, you can balance it just so it stays on there. Let's see if I can do it. Oh, nearly, as you can see. Oh, there we go. Nice, then we have the 6mm and the 10mm block on the end of the that other end. Nice. I didn't bother clearing the bench. It's all point of crawling, make it a bit fun. That humming that here is just the ESC, stock ESC. Oh, can you do it? Oh, nice. And the golden rule with crawling, follow the rear wheels or follow the front wheels. So. Oh, nice. Oh. All right, now do a 5-point turn. That's what crawling's all about, you know, in my opinion. Having fun. The kids love it. There's a... And especially these little ones, you can do this course, like I said, in here, in your house, in your garage, or even outside. I think you might just pass on your L's test to get your license. All right, here we go. Love these old school Chevy hard bodies, square bodies, sorry. And well, on that, this is a hard body car as well. A lot of people love these 1/18 scale. It's going crazy in the market, especially with FMS and Rock Hobby. Oh, nice one. That angle. Oh, can you get it? Can you get it? There, we try a bit more of an angle. Go floor it up there. Go back a bit and then go harder. Yeah, now go. There we go, a bit of wheel speed. Now, sometimes with the teeter totter, because it's kind of balanced, you kind of just got to push it down before you get to it. There you go. Can you get there in time? Now to do it again, squish it down. There we go, we're gonna go the other side. You can always balance it by putting like a screw underneath one side, if it keeps it, if it falls to one side or not. Oh, look at that. And you can always put your timing, you know, like how long people take, how turns. Oh, there we go. Perfect. What do you guys think? Hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, give it a like, share the video. If you haven't, please subscribe. And yeah, I'll see you in there for more. But I don't think it can get over there. But good effort. What do you reckon, Zach? Good fun?
Mad fun.
It is pretty good, eh? All right, guys, thanks for watching.